By the way, so this is gonna be like a bet. What are they even betting for? I bet they're betting for dungeon actually here. I would say Necro the Cove is better, but dungeon is gonna be like way more reliable. I think that's what's happening, yeah. Cove is better on average, but dungeon usually gets their average more often, so yeah. What is the usual dungeon kill strategy in this time playing? Dungeon has actually like very many options on how they can play. Usually just like scout their biome and only then decide what they will be going for. It could be cats, it could be mantos, could just be like quick box tempo into an early desert break, especially with like a castle mid or something like that. Co-player will usually be tempoing every single time. They will pick either Cove or, Bidley or Eovacius, and they will go for like some bird boxes and be trying to break as soon as possible and control mid and then play that mid faction forevermore. Some people also like to flag like some mixes for eventual use, but not immediate power stack use. You did meta, BD meta for example, me Necro, Renny Smoka stuff. Wait, Renny Smoka? What's a Smoka? Something cool in terms of metas, except the cola. Except the cola! Oh no. Oh no. Oh, that is sad. Oh, okay, okay. No one was playing it until Renny showed up in Duel. Maybe. Perhaps. At least certainly not as much, I would say, yeah. What do you think they're betting for? I would say they're betting for dungeon, but I don't agree with it. I think they're betting for dungeon? Yeah, I just don't agree with it. Hey, Harry. Hello, young man. What are you doing up this late? I'm casting an amazing tournament series. This is going to be the decider match. One of them is going to be going to the loser's bracket. The other will be going to the finale of the winner's bracket. They're betting for dominance. That deal. That deal. Not sure you're so stupid. Shell protection on the air. Oh, brought air on them and they become so stupidly hard to kill. Exactly, yes. Rawlock, what is wrong with you? Lakeshev came up with dying on Necro. Oh my god. I mean... No, whatever, anyway. They're not wrong. They are wrong! Bruh. What about our bets? They were already paid out, and now you're gonna be, like, betting. Yeah, the bets are actually live for the last game, actually. So, bet away. Bet away. Dude, they're actually betting, like, so far for this faction pay. That's ridiculous. Retreat. Oh, okay. I will never let Lesha forget I came up with Alien Conflict 2 months before he was meta, and I don't even play this video game. That's true, actually. That is true. The part where Ruffy doesn't play this game is true. I agree, Ruffy. Mm-hmm. 5.2. I think if you want the best so much in faction, you should just use ban. Well, depends. You are also going to be having an expectation of what the opponent will be doing, you see? And based on that expectation, some certain things will be happening. Oh, maybe? Wait, maybe they like will never play... Maybe Karaka will never play without water anymore. Now he's betting for Cove, so he doesn't have to play waterless again. Imagine. It's impressive how they're betting. More than 5k for a faction. You wouldn't pick over the other. Yeah. What time is it for you right now? It's 10 p.m. track team. I can need man up and start betting like civilized beings. Kuraga passes when Gongwazi betting 55. Now, Kuraga should probably know that Gongwazi is going to be bit. Yeah. Whoa! Gongwazi betting 800 for color? This is unprecedented! never seen before. Gone Wilds are making a bet for color. It's ridiculous. We've almost never seen it before happening. But then again, he's gonna be playing like a tempo matchup, so it makes more sense in this matchup than others. That is the case, I guess. In my honest opinion, plus 100 betting should be banned as well. No, it shouldn't be. At this point, you can do a 24-hour stream. You will be 9 hours online anyway. Nah. Not quite. I like to go bets at random, as some people prepare plus 100 bet just to throw them away. Are you still playing WoW? Yes, I am. I'll probably be playing WoW for like a year, about. I'm gonna be playing the entire Wrath expansion. Not sure what I'll do after. The way they bet tells me this will be a 2-4-2 kind of game. 2-4-2? Maybe. I don't see this being a 2-4-2 game, actually. It would be really weird to me if it was. So, we have Gong's Blue Lorelei against the Radio Vaxius of Kuroka in the decider match here. And we immediately see some Harpy Eyes here too. That is amazing for him. So this is already going to be like a keeper Gongwazi. He has a pretty good map. Let's see the map in its entirety. Stronghold side, that's the Cold Biome. Fortress mid again, unfortunately. Neutral side, that could be interesting. Okay. And that is the Dungeon Biome. Okay, Kuroka keeps, and Gong will be keeping as well. Though he actually might be resetting the map of Kuroka. He has like some really good bosses over here. I bought it to play with the Serbian Negro, but I'm already better with her after 2 games and she got man. Wait, Northgard? I see. Lamau. Classic. Will you do me the honor of playing a game while calling marketplaces place of the markets? Nah. But maybe. Hey, thank you, NSLD. Much appreciated. So both players keep the map, and we're gonna be having like a fourth mid again, but also like a neutral side. Well. Let's see. And by the way, Oceanid's on the side of Kuroka. That's actually pretty lucky. Oh, very good. Good start here for both the players on the bunker. Gongwazi ended up getting the Harpy Eggs, his preferred Diplo. And, he will be needing to clone here. Yeah, but with a clone, this is gonna be like a really good head start in Kuroka's army. This is actually gonna be like, wait, this will actually be birds, I think, in super early. Low roll the first hit, that was a little bit unlucky. And now the clones are gone. He will be needing to take some damage here, maybe? Oh, actually, he'll be able to bait the Duke Northstag's back. That's pretty cool. Okay. Okay, minus 22, but for this sort of reward, it's gonna be, like, really good. Kiroka is, like, setting him up for, like, a really good game here so far. Nice! You'd love to see him. Oh my god, Gong actually won that one. Gong won. Gong won, and now we have another game coming up. Already like 56 Harpy Eggs on the side of Gongwazi, by the way. And he has like, he actually did not pick up as well, so he does not have like really good resources. Which is what I was about to say, which would be a mistake. Okay. I would kind of like to see that Sulfur Pot being picked up. Yeah, okay. Seems like he does as well. Pretty good stuff. Then there's also like a sword here as well. Pretty good stuff, yeah. And also make sure to gamble your points away right now before it's too late. It's a one-in-a-life opportunity to lose all your life savings in one good sweep. I think that the gargoyles, the troll dice will definitely be deleted. Can't imagine it going any other way. I wonder if he will be going for, like, the treasury, or he'll be, like, trying to push for his main town immediately. We'll see. Oh, it was actually Perat, not the Bursier. That feels like a low roll for Karaka. Okay. Okay. Here. Okay. Then gonna be able to, like, go for the dungeon down here as well. Has a bird walling. And gonna be able to, like, summon the birds immediately, too. Gonna be, like, a decent setup. Or maybe he might want to summon some other things, like, such as Nyxes. Or maybe even the serpent. I mean, the snakes. He has a snake along the road there, so that could actually be an option here for Karaka. It seems like he's gonna be going for, like, a pretty built-out cove rather than just, like, yeah, rather than just going for, like, tempo call, the way that I usually would be playing it, for example. And some other people do, of course. Seems pretty good. I gambled everything that I own on remaining doing well in sports, following in the footsteps of my father. He lost 20k in 2007. Jesus. Is that true, Ruffy? Are you memeing? Tell me you're memeing. Say, haha, got you. Anyway. We have Gong here, ready to bully some dwarves, as one usually does. It's so sad, yeah. Good past! It's his life. Your past is his life. Okay, so Gong was gonna be able to, like, do this, War Bank, pretty easy. Has to just brawl down the, fast ones, and he's gonna be good to go from here. Yeah. Fresh pasta is the best pasta. Wow. Logistics already for Karaka, but no schools of magic quite can. The level-ups that will be present here for Gong, it's gonna be, like, really, really important. Yeah, let's see him. Air here would be the best. Earth would be second best, of course, naturally. Scouting, logs. Okay, no, he's not level 3 yet. Okay. Oh, he's actually looking to be playing dragons if he's, like, gonna be, like, going for sulfur so aggressively. Interesting. Really, truly interesting. Like, such early commitment to sulfur is very, very, I mean, I've almost never seen it before. Except for, like, when I did it. But, yeah. Well. Oh, Fire Magician on the level 4 level up. That's pretty unfortunate for Gong here. Yeah. He most definitely is looking to reach his main town on this turn, but it looks like he has, like, a pretty good road here. And gonna be able to, like, get 8 knowledge by day 6 here in his main town. Good stuff for Gong. Oh, by now, yeah. Don't doubt the Gong after last win. Well, I mean, you can possibly not doubt Gong, but you can still believe in Karaka, of course. It's not like Karaka is gonna be had, like, a bad game there either. It's just that, you know, like, Gong's strategy just ended up prevailing. Doesn't necessarily mean that it will happen this time, too. It's been lost already, pretty good, and of course, wait, Earth Magic? Did I see Earth Magic on Gong? Wait, what? What did I miss? There was Earth Magic on Gong. Did I just see it? What did I see? Did I see correctly? Huh. Earth Magic level 2. I missed it. When did he even get it? I was, like, following his level up pretty closely. Interesting. But yeah, he does have advanced Earth Magic already. Pretty good stuff for him. And he also has, like, a big helmet on top of all of this knowledge. He's actually going to be having infinite knowledge here, like, really early into the game. He also has, like, 2 dragon caves. pretty much immediately available. He can even, like, summon some dragons right now. Well, actually, he can only summon the psych down, but still, that would be good enough. Or he might actually be playing cats. To me, it looks like Gong is gonna be playing cats, actually. Interesting. No Gamba, you missed it. No, he's actually going for the box, and probably after the box, well, maybe for like a dragon dwelling after all. We'll see. Okay. Oh, Earth Magician on the side of Karaka. Okay, let's go. Well, well. Skirk is now playing Dota 2. Skirk, eh? I'm not sure who is that. Leship, it's very enjoyable to watch you. Thanks. My pleasure. Thanks for being here. Weak on Bird Box. Wait, was that a weak on Bird Box? I was looking at the other player. Of course he's gonna be like building out into Magic University here. And that's what he's currently setting up for the sake of air. Wait. He just got them ore for what? Oh, for the Nyx fort on week one. Okay, that's interesting. So, like, a pretty early Nyx commitment that's coming out here from Karaka. He also bought out the Schools of Magic and also has Sandus on the buy him too. So far, a decent EOF game. But the game here for Gong is looking pretty powerful too. I'm gonna be able to buy out the dragon immediately. But first of all, he's gonna be summoning just to make sure that he can afford the summon. Because that dragon is gonna be gone if not bought out immediately. The other dragons would actually not be gone in comparison. So yeah. In my Kotoni games, have zero bird box, smiley face. I'm going to watch World Finals today. Not sure if I will. I'll see. Does anyone know why Prayer Prey stopped playing? I used to watch him a lot a few years ago. I don't know, probably just, you know, had his fun here and moved on to other things. That's what I assume, but I don't know. I am aware of him, yes. Can you do something about that mouse cursor? Oh yeah, I can. I'm like that teacher that was showing movies with the mouse cursor in the middle, huh? That's mean. I actually lived to the day that I became that person. SMH. Move it over your camera, nose. Oh, it goes below. Interesting. You're to die a hero or live long enough to become the villain. Yeah. Okay, so Mage Guild comes out, then Magic University, it's gonna be... Wait, no, he doesn't need a Magic Uni, he already just rolled for all the schools of magic, which is amazing. Karaka's army is like really good now, his hero progression is amazing as well. So we're once again gonna be seeing like a pretty good game from both of the players. These players just don't disappoint, they don't low roll, they always got it going. How amazing is that? But yeah, look at this mana that Gong is about to have. I wonder which vortex he's gonna be saving, the underground one or the main one? I hate how the international sounds so epic, but I can't watch Dota because it's just so goddamn ugly. What?! Romanians, SMH. Anyway. Gong's army here is gonna be like pretty much good enough to do almost any objective that he wants to do in the biome here by this point. Like Nagbang, stockpiles, he's gonna be able to do all of it and like yeah, gonna be able to succeed off of doing that. Yes. Mm-hmm. He's gonna be doing going for the boss. Yeah, he's currently like just inspecting what he should be doing. Seems like this boss is actually gonna be like the objective. I'm expecting evil eyes here. Or maybe Hoppy Steam. It's absolutely disgusting. Dark Equals Good is the most boring art meta I've ever seen after VTubers. That's not the call what? That's not the art meta for Dota. You just don't know anything about it and you're making assumptions. Not unusual for you, but okay. Open stream is dark. For you, you use dark with synonym with not cartoony enough. What the hell? You understand that, Ruffy? Okay, anyway. We're gonna be seeing the players. Currently, Gongwazi has like pretty decent amount of army, but he's not finding the objective that he wants. What Gongwazi probably wants to do is gonna be like Medusa stores, Dwarven treasuries, Naga banks, and so on. These objectives is what would give him the most amount of experience and the most amount of resource progress, so he can actually build out his biome and be like really, really strong. But he's just not getting it for now, which is like a little bit unfortunate, actually. Did you just call me a weeb? No, not quite. It's even worse. But I don't know what to call it. So many dragons. The dragon stack, yeah, is like pretty good by now. He could probably buy into one more dragon by buying a Polar Summoning in his main town too. But I'm not sure if it's gonna be like a heavy commitment to dragons and a timing attack, or he just has these dragons just to help him farming for now. So yeah, we'll be seeing. He has like many of the magical layers available to him nearby already as well too. Okay, so the Harpy Eyes will be doing like a pretty good job here. Definitely. Ooh. Good morals. Truly. And Kyoto here by this point will be doing like a pretty good job. Yes, indeed. And he gets the resources and the XP. But now he's actually building into dragons, I think. It's gonna be like a black dragon timing attack from the side of Gong. And I believe that is gonna be like his main strategy for now. Meanwhile, Kuroka is just playing like a good, steady, Cove. Good City Cove is gonna be like building out into quite a few Nyxes, and also the biggest stack is gonna be Haspids. Haspids are actually surprisingly easy to build into, compared to something like Dragons, of course. They're not like the easiest to build, but they're like really available, if you actually get like at least a decent game going. The army of Garog is looking so amazing that you could actually just go ahead and break. His viewer's really good, his army's really good. Why not break? Well, because there might be like better opportunities to be had here in the biome than even in the desert, possibly. And you don't want to bleed your army away. That could be like a possible reason why not to break. Yeah. I hope this fool bought his schools of magic in the uni. No, he did not. He rolled for them. Immediately. As one usually does. You don't get this far in the tournament by buying schools of magic, okay? But no, I mean, actually, yeah, two games in a row, they're just rolling their schools of magic by this point. Though Gongwaz, he's gonna be like rolling, yeah, he's counting experience right now because he doesn't want to level up before he actually gets to buy out the before he gets to buy out the, oh, he was actually calculating whether he's gonna be like leveling up in the churchyard and so he could do it for gold. Wow, okay, yeah, that's like the proper thing to do, naturally. Lead answer, what cat is your breed? It's a Siamese. I think. We don't have documents for her, but anyway. She looks like a Siamese, she acts like a Siamese. Buying magic uni, yeah. She's illegal. Can you ride in? Yes. Only losers like us go to buy magic uni 1-2-frame, yeah. Supposed to see army here a little bit, but it's fine. Yeah, takes this fight for free, gets more troglodytes. I thought this would be at least harpies, but unfortunately, not the case. Does she smell like a Siamese? I haven't smelled many Siamese, otherwise she would be angry with me, so yeah. I would say yes. Okay. So, a shield being picked up here. The stats for both players are really good. The armies for both players are really good. Though so far, Kuroka has progressed his game plan like quite a bit further. Because he ended up getting the Air Magician sooner than Gongwazi. And, but still, Gongwazi still can like catch up pretty easily here. Like, look at the Nyx count. Like, week 2 Nyx count. Like, this is insane. It's really strong. Very good. And he's able to go like for every single resource bank immediately, getting even more XP. Pushing his game forward by quite a bit. Nice. If I were buying Alexa and I annoy you, all you have to do is say, play SIF6 Congo music and I'll die. Amazing. Officer says armor being presented here as an option for Kira. Wait, did he go for armor? That would be surprising to me. I mean, no, not that surprising. Not that surprising, but middle faction is Fortress. Actually, yeah, but Fortress mid, I would be confused. I think he did buy... Ooh, critical error. Oof, that's unfortunate. Yes, indeed. Logic is you have less chance to get armor, or Kiraga is just brain... I don't think you can afford to have both offense and, Eovatris is the kind of hero that has, already, like, wanted skill into the game, which is intelligence. I don't think you can afford to have, like, a secondary, two greedy skills with one dead skill. You can afford to only have, like, one greedy skill, like, offense, armor, leadership. Because the main counter to BD is Ogre. It is, and yes, but then again... Ogre Fist scales pretty well with offense too, not only with armor. No, armor is actually good against Ogre Fist. No, wait, that's not the case. Armor is just really good with Ogre Fist as well. Yeah. Okay. I don't know, offense armor, you're Bing Chilling. see guys, crit error often happens. Whenever it happens to me, opponents getting suspicious. Well, yeah, it does look suspicious. I mean, but it is what it is. Yes, it does happen. I see 70 bird, I see offense armor. Yeah. But these players will likely be playing to the late game immediately. I don't think it will actually be like that aggressive towards each other till that stage of the game. Because they value consistency over like immediate value. And that's why they play in that kind of way, I think. One hero with offense versus one hero with just armor. Isn't that better for the offense hero? It depends on the setup and what they want to do. For example, the Black Dragon gamer that's gonna be the Gongwazi this game is gonna be like definitely wanting to have armor because he's just looking to survive enough turns to cast enough spells to kill all the opponent's army, right? But somebody that's gonna be looking to just kill the Black Dragons before all his army dies to spellcasting, which is Kiraga this game, would be likely wanting offense. But of course, there's no reason for Kiraga to assume that he's going up against Black Dragon because the meta for Dungeon recently has actually not been Black Dragons. It's been sometimes Manticores, built up army, tempo into mid, stuff like that, you know? Armor affects the range too, right? Yes, it does. Wait, do we even know what to speak there? I think I'm gonna ask a rock if it's possible to get the Black Dragoon. Bruh. It wouldn't be like that surprising for somebody to like just watching the stream test, but like... Bruh. Why Kiraga wouldn't want to get the Dragon Scepter plus Nyx army with armor? Seems pretty OP. Yeah, if he can like get there, then that's definitely like reelable again. Reelable again. It's just a matter of getting there, you know? And getting there at the proper pace. Like, if you're gonna be giving up mid to the opponent, and you're gonna be letting him like farm up like a mini stats like Gongwazi really likes to do, then even if you get there, it might not just be good enough. Offense is gonna be like more tempo. And also gonna be like more... No, actually armor is more versatile than offense. Interesting. But with a fourth mid... I like armor there, actually. The more I think about it, the more I like armor. My immediate assumption would be offense. But if I think about it, armor makes a lot of sense, yeah. In many situations, it's really good. Okay. Armor effects range 2, right? Armor effects range... Yeah, wait. If you could buff Black Dragon, so would they be completely broken? I mean, if you could avoid all spells but buffs, well, I mean, that'd be something. That would be like a very unique unit, for sure. Not sure if it would be OP, because the build path still sucks. You're a terrible person, man. Because of your stream, I haven't done any work for the last 6 hours. What will my boss say? Your boss will say, why the hell do you keep watching this Lorraine man cast some games? Get back to work. That's what he will say, okay? It is what it is. Imagine affecting all spells but debuffs. Yep. Yeah. That'd be a unique effect. What are your old man casting 60-year-old games? He's in the chat. Nah. Wait, what is this fight? Wait, is it the break already? Oh, okay, Karaga Breaker 127. That makes sense. Because Army is like both definitely good enough for the break, and there's not exactly like a big reason for him to delay this. Yeah. Clean fight, and then gonna be like pushing into middle. He does not have that much mana. I wonder if he's gonna be able to like reach it down here in this thing. We'll see. He's still awake, yeah. Hey, Mercy. Discussing animals, never buying uni again, SMH. Yes, indeed. Is this Witcher? Yeah, probably. Oh, wait, Utopia! Okay, alright, let's see it. Let's see it. It looks like a tier 2. Maybe tier 3? I haven't seen. Okay. Tier 3! And he gets a bunch of garbage, that's pretty unfortunate. Yeah, that's a pretty bad Utopia. Not a single best of Sod Arty, and not even, like, ones that will be good along the way to getting there. No Gusto Cornucopium, no Angelica Lion pieces, and no Tums. Like, what? From tier 3, you get, like, 0. That's unfortunate. But he was probably looking for the gold more so than anything else, to be able to, like, build out into gold dragons as soon as you possibly can. He's got 10 helm, he's chilling. He already had like pretty much infinite knowledge. Alongside vortexes, he will never be having mana issues ever again, with or without this helmet that he just got from the Utopia. It doesn't really change anything. Was a blind account, maybe. It's really annoying. Oh my god.
Kitty, come back!
Oh my god. I'm angry. Oh, by the way, armor offense on the side of Gongwazi, by the way. I just now realized, yeah. What was that? Don't worry about it. Okay, then the Utopia being taken here is gonna be, okay. Listen, nobody wants to be Alkin at home. Meanwhile, both champions, we pick armor at home. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, armor is good, for sure. Nyx is here being cloned for the Utopia. Okay, let's see if Karaga's the Utopia gonna be like any better. Gongwazi last game got like a pretty lucky Utopia. Slightly better, but pretty much the same. Like, not really that much goodness here. Yeah. They don't really... Like, this. Both the Utopias for both players actually doesn't really change anything in the way that you play, you know? You don't gain like a new threshold of stats. And oh my god, he actually got another box here. And now he gets to like buy out all the rest of the birds. Wow. That's gonna be like massively powerful. 37 Nyx on the beginning of week 3? I believe that's the cap of Nyx that you can get almost. And then he's gonna be able to upgrade these immediately. This is like one of the most ridiculous 1-for-1 Cove armies that I've ever seen. And these stats as well. Absolutely ludicrous. But there's a problem. There's a very big problem. Lack of scouting. Garaka does not have scouting, so he's not going to be able to like find, possibly, some of the essential objects for this game. Such as Air Tome, Air Orb. These are going to be like very hard finds without scouting, for sure. And as long as he doesn't add them, he's not realistically going to be able to push Gong. And if Gong gets to the timing of Black Dragons, he might just be able to outscale. Well, not outscale. Like, long-term Karaka would still win with Nyxes, but, there would be a timing where Gong has, like, a pretty good advantage, actually. The game is over. The game is not over. You would have loved to see the last game. You probably would have called it over like an hour ago in the wrong direction. Just like pretty much all of us did, including me. Well, he saw some help. I gave him at least 1% chance. Okay, Sandals here too. Who threw the last one? Last one was one with Armor the Damned into a siege battle to cast Slow right after the Haste. And the two times bigger army ended up just losing by never connecting. It was a siege battle and the fortress had Grail. So the fortress player never came out, of course. He was like fighting in the Grail, but that ended up being like a downside. Because the artillery shoots first, procs the Ogre Fist, then the catapult shoots after, procs the AOTD. And of course there's the anti-dispel orb available, so all the army gets permaslowed for 50 turns. And the titans ended up defeating, like 60 titans ended up defeating like 300 birds, 200 wyverns, a bunch of ancient behemoths and so on. How the fuck do you dig Grail on one hero? There's only one obelisk, and it reveals the entire map immediately in the desert. You can actually dig it out, it's not that difficult. It's like minus like one and a half turns. I mean, but for a Fortress Grail, 10-10 defensive might stats, it's definitely worth it, on top of the income too. Okay. I mean, the desert side for Gongwazi here is looking like okay, but not really that amazing yet. But as long as he can get some decent artifacts going and also can upgrade his dragons at a reasonable timing, then he's gonna be like just fine. I wonder if Karaga's gonna be like more looking for the late game or he's gonna be like trying to push. I believe that this decision will actually be made by whether he gets scouting or not. If he does not roll into scouting, then he will most definitely have to like finish the game at like some early point. But if he does get scouting, then he can go like as late as he wants to. Of course, it's like his like game plan is really good here. Last fight was like heavily armored Romans versus agile Norsemen. Is Diplo removed? No, but it's 50% on only the side zones. Mid and Biome is 25%. Oh yeah, the winner of last match also didn't have Diplo too. The loser had Diplo and actually Diploed a bunch of army. After seeing the last game, I'm never gonna buy Citadel mid as a stronghold player ever. Interesting. Okay, so Karaka's ready to push mid here, and he's like farming up like pretty well alongside him. So far Karaka's like getting like pretty much everything that he needs without scouting, which is pretty impressive. But, you know. There might be like a few vital objects that he will not be able to get, and that will be like very painful for him, of course. Now, there's no view spells on the side of Gongwazi either, which could be quite a bit... Yeah, it could... Which could prove to be like very painful. Are they moving at the same time until they leave side zones, or how it works? They are playing simultaneous turns until 1-7, because usually before 1-7, nobody like fights. So that's the sim... That's what sim turns we use. Already the Kuras being collected by Gongwazi. Getting his power to be pretty high. He almost has the Thanos Kuras too. I mean, the Thanos Thunder. Which is, not very relevant, but I just thought I would mention it. Ooh, okay. Cornucopium. And then a Utopia too. These are exactly the kind of objectives that Gongwazi wants right now. He needs to get the Black Dragons ASAP and resource things as well as gold. As well as Utopias is gonna be like It's what will get him there, basically. Why isn't this ghoul premium? That's the lit one now. That is the lit one, but this is the Golden Goose tournament, so that it's running with the more official version. So let's see. My cat just goes on the lighting, exactly. Just to block it away from me completely. Okay. Already Golem Wazzy is looking like pretty strong, but... ooh. Oh, goes for the interference and then the permissized steam. I mean, Black Dragon Gamer will probably want to have like pretty high power, actually. I can see that being the case. Sure. Yeah. Who won the Blue Naga Man versus the Green Ogre Man match? The Blue Naga Man won. Is Golem Wazzy playing casual duel matches? Yes. Caress and some more premise styles, that's pretty good. Mm-hmm. Oh, the cat's here, she sent him to fly. Show her. Please do it. Okay. Mm-hmm. It's here, kitty. No, it's here, please, look at it, look, what's here? Kitty! Why blind? God damn it. Useless creature. Okay, so... wait, did we see, like, Karagi getting anything big here? He's pushing to the middle of the desert, he ended up getting, like, a box, he ended up getting some permastats, and, yeah. He has, like, a few more boxes locally that he will be able to collect, and Gogwazi... here, it's gonna be like going for the Utopia, some more permissized steam. Gonna be on pretty high power, actually. Mm-hmm. There we go. So. Okay, shield comes out, and actually I don't really like shielding much in this position, because sometimes shield gets your dragon to get focused, and dragons is like the creature that you want to get focused last, of course, because, ooh, hello. Seems fine. Oh, whoa, that's a Utopia! Two best assault artes immediately. The necklace and, of course, the fabled air tome are very relevant, very big. I wonder if Gong Wazzy would be pushing here immediately with this air tome. Wow. Okay. Hinted the cat off the camera. No, it didn't. The cat just moved out the camera after she hunted the fly. What do you mean? Okay, I mean that was... oh, he also found the goose. He already has the cornucopium too. Okay. That's really big. Yeah, very, very big, actually. Uh-huh. Okay. Not as big as Fitzy. Wow, okay. I see. And no, didn't end up going for the Golden Goose quite yet. I see. Golden Goose is gonna be able to like assemble quite a bit of army here. Ooh, by the way, only one stack. Can probably just do it with the clown, right? Yeah, easy. Mm-hmm. Basilisk, eh? And then it's able to get it down. But now it will be... like, we don't know what the last skill of Karaka is going to be. That will be very heavily influencing the outcome of the game. If he rolls into scouting, we're going to be probably like, maybe having like a late game type of match. But if he doesn't, then we're probably going to be clashing like pretty early. Karaka will definitely not be trying to pull off a late game here without scouting. Well, I see definitely. I could maybe see it happening, but I wouldn't say it's going to be like very likely at all. Yeah. And I'm resource sauce. It's kind of whatever. Goose and Cornucopium are already like super good, relevant things. Making them even better would be... like, there's no reason to buff these RPs more than they already are good. The building as well. I mean, the meta is like building in a lot anyway, already. Getting like goose coin, you get generating resources, building up income, flagging dwellings and so on. Okay, Gong is actually like making a commitment towards even more dragons, of course. Just came back, who's winning? It's too hard to say right now. It's a close match. It's gonna be like very much based on timings and also like some outcomes that are gonna be, that we'll be seeing like in a little bit. Gorgons, okay. Quite a few of those by now. Gets like some more prem power too. And gonna be going for like even more resources here as well. Nice. Is Black Dragon Temple faster than your Gold Dragon Strat Lexi? It's basically the same. It's gonna be like a early week 4 timing that's gonna be when they're gonna be relevant. Yeah, it's basically the same. By the way, I used Jelly to make it happen. He was using a Lorelei that he had no gold on, you see? So it was easier for me to make it happen. But Gold Dragons are generally harder to make happen than Black Dragons, so... yeah, it goes... there's all sort of stuff there. Mm-hmm. I think the same, but it's really nearly impossible to enforce rare play. Okay. These tests are bold players are really good. But I'm most excited to see Kuroka's last level up, actually. It's gonna be like basically the start of the game. Yeah. Oh, okay, so he has like some vision over here, so that's where he's heading to. Makes sense. Farm up things that you know you can farm instead of like trying to walk blindly all throughout the desert. Makes a lot of sense here, naturally. If he had an air tone, then I believe there would be like quite a bit of aggression going on. Because Garaga's position is amazing right now. Like mid control, Arthes, army, everything is like top notch right now. But, yeah. Ooh, he missed the scouting. Guess the decision between fire match and archery. That is very unfortunate. The miss scouting throughout the entire skill tree. You see, I'm always happy to get scouting, and you always see me like happy to get scouting, but there's games like this where you don't get it that actually makes scouting actually amazing, you know? And now Karag will have to like pretty much blindly walk into an air town. If he ever wants to go aggressive. Until then, he'll just have to, like, farm whatever is, like, in front of him. It's not a very good feeling. Yeah. I mean, he did have, like, a really good skill tree until now, by the way. He rolled for Earth and Air immediately without buying it out in the Magic Uni. So, you know, it was a pretty good position for him to be in, but now finally gets punished as well. Yeah. I think Glitch have his better casting then. Oh. Just get the tower in neutral, build Grail, and it's good. Finding the Grail without scouting is gonna be like pretty good card. You have to find the obelisk, you have to find a position, and so on. I went to AFK for a moment. What the fuck, how Karag lost with Grail? It was AOTD tech coming out from Gongwazi. It was a 5-hand win, a very cool one, yeah. Major level 3 is here, so we're about to see, like, the Black Dragons already be available. Decently early timing, too. Arthur Merchants comes out, and oh my god, by the way, Gongwazi is, like, running out of timer, and he's, like, being pretty slow right now. Unacceptably so. Buys out the Mantis, and then... Hardgrim, and gonna be pushing into the side zone, I guess, yeah? Yeah, 17 seconds, my friend. Okay. Isn't buying magic not that much worse since you get 2-3 level ups for free? Yeah, but it's still like a really big commitment. Oh, by the way, fire archery on both players, by the way. Ancient Behemoths actually available. I mean, he got some. Finds Utopia here to do. Gonna be able to go for the economy. And yeah, gonna be good to go. It's not that much worse, but you have to go ahead and flag the conflicts down. You have to invest most of your early game gold, a lot of wood and a lot of ore into buying it out. The two levels that you get are actually like pretty meaningful and good, but if you can avoid spending that, then it's even better. Because the opportunity cost is high. It's actually really high. Yep. Mm-hmm. Ooh. Okay. very much will depend on the when is going to be the timing for Karolka's airtime, actually. I believe that will be very heavily influencing his decision-making, too. So, yeah. With Monarch's Box, that's an amazing one. He already has like over 35 ins here already. And it does look to me like Rock is gonna be like going rather aggressive here towards Kongwazi. He doesn't really have like much of a choice here. Trying to play the late game without scouting is just like so painful. You kinda see the stats, the libraries, the essential arties that you need to collect. Like none of that information is available to you. And that is painful for sure. How many child points do I need to be to get to be allowed to name your first born child? Joke's on you. No, I'm not gonna go there. Bro, what the fuck? Why you need scouting just map hack? Yeah, easy. Easy. You can see like his efficiency of like throughout the streams is like getting worse and worse. You would be expecting a player with a middle control that many moves this much army to be doing like more per turn than what he's currently doing. He's doing his best, but that's an unfortunate situation to find yourself in, truly. Scouting just used V-Air, bro. Lol. Yeah. Oh, Goose. He actually still needs them. I wonder if he's gonna be like pushing for the town immediately or will be picking up the Goose. I'd like to see the Goose. I actually feel the library being there too. Ooh, breath his own Gorgons. But then again, he didn't have like many better options. He needed to breath something here, or he wouldn't have gone for the Utopia at all. A near tome. Not really that good. I'd like to see the Goose here being farmed. Yeah, it is. Oh wait, the stables in the stronghold! Oh wait, yeah! Interesting. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. That could be pretty cool. Question, why Valley Scouting so much? I follow pro player Dream Hunter and he doesn't take scouting most games. Okay, bro. Yes indeed. Okay. So, Utopia being here, and also like the sort of judgment on the north side as well. Some pretty good finds for Karaka. It's a tier 1 Utopia though, so that's pretty unlucky. Unless it's exactly an air tome. Is it exactly an air tome? Let's see it. I wonder if he would win if he were to attack with an air tome right now. It'd be pretty tough. Yeah, he has most tomes, but not the tome, unfortunately. Did somebody find a proof about Dream Hunter, by the way? No, I don't think there's any definitive proof yet. Oh, that's an air tome! Oh my god, just runs into one. I mean, yeah, I guess you don't need scouting. That's pretty good. Yeah, that's pretty good. So now, I believe the Karaka is probably gonna be like going full aggressive. I can't imagine a scenario where he's not. I don't imagine, yeah, at all. But I think Gongwazi will just be barely in time squeezing out the Black Dragons, which will be making for a very good timing deal. So, you know. Lexi is still on, but I'm fully drunk. WTF. Hey, Wazi. Yeah, look at that. 41 power. But there's gonna be like quite a bit of an interference on the side of Gong, and also these Black Dragons will be just destroying. But like, Nyxes are pretty good against us. So, yeah, there's gonna be like a timing where Gong will still be probably like really powerful here, but we'll see. This double mana is gonna be like pretty excessive. Kinda silly. I mean, he's a dungeon player with two vortexes, he doesn't really need this. But, I mean, maybe nice at some point. Mikas? Next plus HP, son. Wait, HP, son? Does he have the HP set? I wonder. I mean, HP set, protections, Nyxes, and loss of Nyxes, by the way. Like, Araka's Nyx stack is like pretty ridiculous right now. One of the best Nyx stacks that I've seen at this stage of the game. Maybe they were like of slightly better ones when they were used to be like still like way more co Nyx dwellings before they were nerfed, but yeah. I think that Gong will be looking to start the turn here on the stables. I mean, the next turn. The 1-for-1 beginning of the week on stables is gonna be like pretty nice, maybe. I can't really imagine him going for any other reason here. Yeah. Oh yeah, he still needs the sword, deal. Yeah. So we're gonna be like picking up the sword and then, yeah, going to the stables and then here. That is probably gonna be like pretty wonderful. Then the entirety of the next week is gonna be stabled up. Very amazing for Gong. Yep. So let's see the aggressive efforts of Garoha. I mean, ooh, another box here. Pretty cool. Basilisk, and then, oh, another Earth Elm. Well, yeah. Wait, he wants to go for a Cornucopia, me? Even Dwelling? Oh, look at that PDF package. But probably not too interesting. Oh, he goes back? Okay. So, I thought that there would be, like, an aggressive push, but I guess he doesn't feel like he has enough mana to, like, keep himself in that position. So, we'll instead go back and rally up to quite a bit of army. Upgrade the vibrance and do like many more things. I wonder if he's just delaying the attack or he's gonna be like not attacking in general, so yeah. Mm-hmm. He has like 20 Nyxes to buy to him. Yeah. Ridiculous stuff. Maybe with, like, the sort of timing he's gonna be, like, pushing. But then again, I think Gong Wazi would actually not even mind that whatsoever. Mm-hmm. Okay. I wonder if he'd be going, like, for the underground right now. There's gonna be, like, quite a few stats there. And Gong Wazi is not one to shy away from getting, like, lots of stats. He's even going for quite a bit of this stronghold army, actually. Rather surprising to me. Okay. Seems like he's not very interested in the bunker. Okay. I mean, I can see why. What is the second, semifinal? It is Yellen versus, Tim, I believe. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's, Yellen versus Tim, and they're gonna be, like, playing on Monday. I mean, depending on when they play, I might be trying to catch that as well. Mm-hmm. I came in like 20 seconds ago and was wondering how you were making those movements with one hand in the air, and then I realized you are commentating. Yeah. Yeah. There's actually so many dragons available for them. If he like buys them all out and upgrades them into black dragons, then there's gonna be like a very fierce timing that he's gonna be having against Garaga. Little does he know that Garaga does not have scouting, so he might actually like play a long game and do it well. But still, that would be like pretty dangerous to do against the next stack that is gonna be like coming out here. Not to mention the vibrance too, for example. Tim? Wait, isn't it Tim? If I'm wrong, you can correct me. Isn't the other semis Yellen versus Tim? I don't know those players. Tim 101, I play him like all the time. Yellen also is gonna be like the guy that I usually play against with a more chill timer too, sometimes. Actually, been a little while since our last game. What, Tim? What? He called Gong Tim. Did I? My bad. Didn't I say Gong? Wait. Oh, Gong. Anyway, it's Yellen versus Tim. Tim is the scared Russian guy. He's not scared at all. What? Oh man, this army for Garog is getting like pretty ridiculous. He ended up getting sandals here. Not sure if he still needed those, but if he did, that's a pretty good find. He goes back. I wonder what he's looking for by now in terms of RTs. I think he's just like looking to progress his game, like no matter what. Didn't look up the goose yet. Didn't have the timer. Okay, and also didn't make fast. A little bit unfortunate. The upgrades there were a little bit greedy. Maybe he didn't get proper beeps. Mm-hmm. It's Gong vs. Garaga. No, somebody asked what the other finals were. Like, what the other semifinals were. And it's Yellen versus Tim. Isn't that what I said? Anyway, I may have said, like, Gong versus Tim or something. Anyway. Okay. Oh, four more ABs. By the way, like, this AB stack is actually becoming something as well. That's very surprising. He's able to, like, make these stacks out of thin air. At least that's what it looks like. 19 dragons as well. But he needs, like, more Utopias. Oh, there's actually a Utopia on the south side. We can see him right now. Okay, he's going for, like, the Biometopia now. No, he already got that one. Okay. He's just looking to collect him in more stats. Interesting. Oh, no, more dragons. Not more stats. I thought he was gonna be, like, going to the Colosseum. Okay. And yeah, now he's, like, setting up for the possibly aggressive push with the Black Dragons. Which is gonna be, like, very, very powerful. Yeah. Confusion of the Higher Order. Yeah. I wonder if it's worth spending a turn, collecting 20 nicks from dwellings, and try to end before Montiel. Possibly, yeah. I mean, both players are like rallying all that they have in order to get like a big push going. So both are actually like in a very similar spot right now. Yeah. That is a mean looking dragon stack. It is. It is for sure. Oh wait, sorry. I'm Pepega. Let's check, can we get the Darkest Dungeon OST? I'm just letting YouTube autoplay. It's usually most of the soundtracks that I like already, anyway. Okay. So. Wait, it's gonna be Gong Wazi's turn, and Gong Wazi is like trying to upgrade all of his dragons to get the push going. He's really close in terms of resources to being able to do so. Oh no, he still had to buy the building. And he still has like even more dragons to buy, so he's not even like that close to being able to afford it. He at least sees like one more Utopia. He sees one in the Shongle side zone. So I believe that's the way he should be going, like exactly. Take that Utopia, set up the attack, and then just go! Push! Mm-hmm. Yeah, 30 Black Dragons on, like, week 4. Well, not 30, it's gonna be, like, 27? No, 26. Oh my god, he actually managed to buy out and upgrade them. Actually, okay, I was wrong. Cool. Wait, he sold his economy! He's all in! He pushed the pot! Into the middle! And he is all in right now! Completely pushing here. Oh no, he just... Interesting. Codicopium! I mean... Yes, Elixir completed! Wow, okay! Tim is coming! Tim, jeez, I'll make it. Okay, listen, I'm tired as well, okay? Gong is coming for middle! And gonna be attacking Karaka in mid here. I believe that Karaka is gonna be like mustering his best defense here. Without, okay, he's gonna be going for Ogre first. Oh, against the Black Dragons, of course. Okay. Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. Why wouldn't you? Mm-hmm. Tim owning. Shut up. Go, Tim. Shut up. I don't want to hear it. Don't happen right now. So yeah, the Ogre Fist. This is like one of the earlier Ogre Fists that we've seen, actually. It's, will it give speed priority to Karaka? I don't believe it will. And these stats are like looking really low. Oh, and he's hiding it as well. Okay, okay. So now, it's up to, what the hell? Okay, he just, like, replays the turn. To see whether Karaka made any moves there that he can see. And the answer is no. Elixir. Yeah, okay. Has a proper setup. Sees no defense. Mm-hmm. And then he understands what's going on exactly. Mm-hmm. Gonna be able to get the... library and then push on to the middle town. And yeah, gonna be seeing the army, but I believe that he's gonna be like not afraid and he will be just pushing forward. Okay, maybe you want the... Whoa, the Fire Dome! The Fire Dome might win the game! With the Fire Madness here! It's gonna be an AoE Berserk, but not an expert one, unless he, like, levels up from this fight, exactly. No, he doesn't. So it's gonna be, like, Advanced Berserk here. Unfortunate. But still, pretty good. He doesn't have, the Lion Shield either. He's missing, like, a lot of stats. Okay, keeps the, equips the minus luck instead of the... other option there, okay. Oh, he actually got the Speed Prial! Okay, okay. The Speed Prial matters a lot here. And he's gonna be able to connect these, birds as well as the, and he can even prayer up immediately. Kuroka looks to have, like, solved this issue completely. Expecting the Black Dragons, he made the perfect setup to be able to, like, deal with this. Yeah, speed 11, plus 6, plus 1 from the terrain, they were, like, easily outspeeding the Black Dragons. Well, the main problem is that Kuroka is lacking, like, a little bit in stats, so he might not be dealing, like, that much damage, despite being able to connect here immediately. So, yeah. Over 1k mana. Yeah, but I don't think it will actually come down to mana, that's the point. That's the problem. What's the difference between Advanced and Base Berserk? You get some AoE. It gets bigger and bigger as you scale it up with Fire Magics. Okay, so the Berserk is gonna be like completely scary for Kuroka, but he might actually underestimate him. I mean, he might not actually consider him, yeah. The death and power difference. Ooh, okay. Wait, how many was that? 12 Vibrants just ended up getting defeated by the Aces. And yeah, Kuroka is immediately moving out. Alright. And gonna be connecting onto the Black Dragon, see him. Kills 5 back. Wait, this actually exposes maybe like a weakness. Where Gongwaza can maybe play inside the castle and block the entrance back from the gold player. Down to 21 Black Dragons. That's somewhat painful. There's also like a decent Breath Guard too, available to him. Wayfarer Black Dragons, you can do it against DX units, but you cannot do it against 1-hex units, unfortunately. And the biggest stack is actually 1-hex, which is the Nyxus. Well, these three stacks, Wyverns, Aces, and Nyxus, are all, like, decently similar. Yeah. The Elixir is present on both sides. You can actually... he could Berserk, like, quite a few units, but I don't think that would be good enough either. Wait, is there anti... Dispel Orb? Well, no. I mean, he's, Gongwaza doesn't have, like, the amount of water magic anyway. Which makes sense. I mean, Kuroka finding, like, the Ogrefist here without scouting is, like, pretty impressive. And this timing especially. He ended up seeing all the Arthes and he knew what he needed to do. Okay. So, currently, the strategy is gonna be, like, in Kuroka's favor. Ogrefist against the Black Dragon. Damn, shut up, Rito. The harpies here are still, like, pretty lively. And also, like, the behemoths are gonna be able to do quite a bit too, maybe. There's both armor and offense on the side of Gong. So maybe, just maybe. I mean, the casting is definitely on the Gong side. Infinite mana. Yeah, I mean, it's 1000 mana, yes, but you should basically, like, just consider it as infinite mana. Yeah. Doesn't the Dragons just go inside and win now? Not exactly. There's gonna be teleports available, summons available, and many other things that are gonna be, like, present. But it seems actually, yes, to be, like, the plan of Gong, after all. Because, you know. Then again, like, two of these tags being flying is the annoying part, I guess. I'm hypnotized. Hey, WP. Thank you. I wonder what the cats here from Gongwaza will be. I certainly have no idea what this cats will be, actually. Oh yeah, it's a chain, of course. And it's a very good chain, too. I'm hitting, like, three of the essential stacks of Kuroka immediately. I, for some reason, thought the prediction from Mirror came out, but clearly it was Prayer, of course. Yeah. Okay, so he's heading inside. He's got some morale, which actually I should use. He should probably use it on defend. Yeah, I think defending would have been better. It would be very protective against summons. It would be not actually against summons now, but against like the spirit stacks. Yeah, it would be protective. Oh, very much so. Unlucky. Okay. Mm-hmm. Has that even a surprising cast in this chain lightning simulator of a template? That's what surprises me, because I missed the part where he prayed instead of protection. Yeah, my bad. Wait. Actually, morale difference is big. Kind of, yeah. The leadership from the lore league is doing, like, quite a bit of work here. Maybe there could be, like, a decently big berserk. No, not yet, not yet. It would be 3 stacks on a berserk. It's not bad, but it's not, like, what you need quite yet. Maybe if he were to, like, expose his Black Dragons, maybe Karaku would be, like, falling for it, basically. I don't think so. You cannot make it blatant. Yeah. You cannot make this Berserk play blatant. This Berserk might actually be, like, the deciding factor here in this fight, but, you have to catch it, you know? You most definitely have to catch a timing with it. Mm-hmm. Is it 100% chance for Chaos to steal troops? They don't steal troops, they kill part of the stack, and it's not 100%. It's 10% per one unit, but at a limit, and that limit is basically like 1 plus 1 more per 10-ish. I don't know. Does Berserk activate retaliation? Yes. They respond as if they were, like, regularly attacked. Summons comes out here from Gongwazi. Okay. Which is might lead, both in terms of stats and in terms of armor offense. It's a pretty decent play to make, of course, to just summon some early and just, like, start brawling some of these things down. 110 from the number of Mighty Gorgons in a rounded, in a stack rounded up. In other words, well, it's like 11 can mind kill you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Stupid army, why retaliate for some berserk stack? It should be like that when both stacks are berserked. No, no. Max roll attack on air. Wait, was it? Was it a high roll? I didn't notice. Okay. Honestly, Gongwazi might be doing this. Karaga prepared, like, really well for this attack, but, I feel like it was really greedy to prayer up an attack here, against Gong. If he protection from Merit on the first turn instead of prayer immediately and attack, I feel like, Karaka here would be in a better spot than he is right now. But it's still, like, a pretty hard find. I believe that a situation where only the, Nyx Warriors are living would be pretty likely. In that case, Berserk would be king, naturally. Jesus, Rita. Won the Grail game. The non-Grailer won against a Grailer. Okay, so what is gonna be the next cast of Gong? It might just be more summons, to be honest. That would make a lot of sense. Of course, the units are here protected by now. From air. So, the air elementals begin to be, like, the most reasonable way to deal damage. And as long as he can get rid of everything apart from the Nyxes, then he's gonna be, like, able to find lethal eventually. These Black Dragons are doing, like, a really good job in brawling too. Tim, shut up, you morons. Oh, the Harpy survives. I wonder if that's even that useful. Oh, we'll see. Is fireball damage anytime relevant? No. If it's not, well, maybe you could, like, find a super ultra niche situation, but most usually not. Why do fire dragons become black dragons? The red dragons become black dragons, but anyway. Red become dark? Try again, Marcus. Try again. Mm-hmm. Okay. The fat little orange hamster, is that Marcus? Yes, indeed. Okay, so now Gong is gonna be like having a cast, and it will probably be air elementals, I guess. No, chain? I'd be very surprised to see a chain here. Yeah, I'd be very surprised. But why? He treats these vibrants with with the utmost urgency. Maybe because he wants to block the corpse. Or maybe he just wants to disable sacrifice place from being any good. That could be like a way to think about this. Karakus should discast protection from fire to reduce Black Dragon's damage by 75%. You should drink an anti-fire potion. Oh my god, that shadow of something on the wall. Something? Not really sure what. Anyway. Okay, so the vitamins are gone. So there's only like a few stacks remaining for Karaka that can actually catch, that can prevent the Berserk from killing him. Okay. Sure. How do you get the 1k mana? He has intelligence, he had like very high knowledge, and then he used up the Vortex Steel. So yeah, Sacrifice Play came out, after all, but this time on the birds. So there's gonna be like not that many stacks remaining for Karaka, yeah. I bet Karaka is gonna be like trying to set up maybe... Actually, I'm surprised by Karaka not trying to set up maybe some sort of clone play. Eight to 15 birds. He's not dealing like that much damage on the Black Dragons at all by this point. I mean, against the Elixir, against like... Actually, no, he's killing like 20 birds. That's actually pretty good. He should be able to like just overall that, maybe. Okay. It's a giant fly trying to rule... You know that the clones are slower than Black D, right? Yeah, but his birds are faster, which means that if he waits on the birds, he's gonna be like the last one to play. And if he's the last one to play, then the birds will actually move after the Black Dragons. You know that, right, Stygian? Like, bruh. Oh, he's still got double clone play. Yeah, he does. The double clone might still be relevant here from the Duel of Ashes. Mm-hmm. He didn't breath attack Nyx and Kao in that turn when he morale. Now he's gonna lose. He needed to be defensive here because the Gongwazi is the one winning the fight long term, and hitting there would be the short term solution. You see, that is the issue. Okay. Man, if the Gorgons were not that fast. Well, anyway. Oh, he's counting like which hexes would be able to like hit the Gorgons here. You see, that's what he's doing exactly. I also wouldn't like hate an Ice Bolt on the Aces either. It's not even that bad. But still. We'll see. Oh, okay, that's a good summon. And by the way, he defends on the Black Dragons. Which actually I don't like, because I feel like defending on the Black Dragons enables a clone play more. You're playing around clone if you hit there, I feel like. But I guess he's afraid of the fire shield too, which is like pretty relevant in his decision making. Okay. Ogre Bonk, yeah. Ogre Bonk would be quite something too. Be a brief human, don't end. Hello, Shaman. Is Superman still banned because the dual prospect is too strong, or have they unleashed the beast? They have unleashed the beast. I think you're struggling. Much appreciated. But damn. Like, not every player's like dealing like that much damage. Kuroka ended up like casting quite a few buffs here that yeah, it's pretty relevant. Kuroka's options here. I guess, yeah, Kuroka is currently, like, setting up for a clone play with the bears. That's why he ended up waiting here. Clearly, it's, like, clone play setup. I wonder how fast Nyx are. They're gonna be, like, 8 on this terrain, then gonna be 13, and then gonna be 17. Speed 17 Nyx, that's pretty amazing. Okay. So, wait. He cannot, like, do anything fancy with Berserker, I think. Yeah. Clone or Clown? Clone. Yubashi's specialty gives him 2 clones on the first cast of clone in the fight, and he still hasn't used that double clone, and right now I think that he's setting up for exactly that play. So, there we go. Doubt he can do anything. He lost a lot of dragons already. But, like, the... It's up to Kuroka to end the fight. If the fight continues, it's gonna be like in Gong's advantage. And I don't think that Kuroka's like running out of fuel, and Gong-wise, he will be able to pull through. But we'll see. No, he cannot do that, Floggy, because the birds are moving last alongside Nyxus, you see. If they were like not two stacks moving, then yes, that would be possible. But like the Nyxus would be able to like do something about the Berserk. And that's the problem. Right now he has like a few options. He could be trying to like summon again and then like apply more pressure and then try to just like survive with the dragons by defending. Another option would be to try and like ice bolt plus hit the burst to make them like weigh less. And that would lead into a position where the clone is gonna be like summoning like a lot more. You get like 20 with the ice bolt, 20 with the attack, and then suddenly there's only like 30 birds being cloned. Which would be definitely somewhat relevant. That early Nyx investment won the game. It's definitely relevant, but I wouldn't say it's winning the game right now, you know? Because, well, he might not be winning the game. Simple. Not a meme. Resistance plus dwarf specialty is unstoppable if they are masked. It's winning the game for one player. Interesting. For Tim. Stop. He's considering that Berserk, but I don't think it's actually gonna be like that again. I feel like Ice Bolt plus it is actually pretty irrelevant. Well, yeah, I'll probably just Ice Bolt plus it here on the bears. He just needs to get the stack down, and he's gonna be, like, lethaling with his Berserk very, very soon. What? But what does that do? It prevents a... This prevents, This prevented a fly play, but really? Is that what you thought was the most dangerous thing out of all here? I feel like that was a misplay of... The highest order. Oh, he's actually focusing the aces, not on the black drag. Oh, he's just focusing the clones. Wow. He didn't kill one! Because he unlucky actually didn't kill one, and he didn't proc the ferocity, by the way. For like aces don't have double attack like wolves do, okay? They instead have ferocity. And ferocity states that you attack a second time if you kill at least one unit, which they didn't do. Which means that the clone egg actually here was like pretty weak. Yeah. Oh my god. Those downlights were like devastating for Kuroka. Yeah. I came by to ask how come I got like 550k points when I entered 250k bets on keyboardless play yesterday. I didn't manage to watch the whole game. Well, you can check it out. 77 can't kill one. Pathetic. Well, they're the unbuffed ones, and the stat difference is actually pretty huge as well. So, there's that. Yeah. The song is from Gears 5. Yes, it is. Alright. Pray once more. No? Did really Shambik in the game, or how come he lost? Like, we're doing this game right now. Okay. Wait, there's gonna be Sacrifice? Sacrifice would make, like, the upcoming close cycle a little bit better, but then he also needs to, like, There's not many good casts from here for Kira. Actually, I maybe would like summon Steer, but it kind of depends. You'll probably want to do summons towards the end of the turn so they can confirm a hit then. But once again, it's not really that powerful. Is Augur for 50 turns? Yes, it is. Augur 50 turns. I think that Gong lost quite a bit of tempo by berserking the Nyxus there. I wonder what the idea was. He just doesn't want the Nyxus teleported, I think, onto the dragons. I think that was the idea, maybe. But I don't think that was Garaka's idea. Yeah. Oh, teleport? Yeah, okay, teleport now happens. And that's fine, probably. The birds will be exposed to, like, a new air elemental stack that might be coming out, but we don't know for sure yet. Yeah. Okay. He's killing one dragon. Well, a little bit more than one, but still. Oh, but he also unlocked, but then he also retaliated into the fire shield, which is gonna be, like, painful for the black dragon to deal. Yes, indeed. Okay. As long as Garaka keeps up two stacks, he might be able to still win, but... It's not like the Berserk is gonna be like coming in as a surprise to Garaka at all, as Gongwazi has already shown it. So yeah. It's kind of a shame that he doesn't have Meteor Shower. Meteor Shower would be like very relevant here in this kind of thing. Yeah. It's actually ridiculous the fire shields works against black dragons. It just makes sense. No, it actually does. Like, if shield works against black dragons, then fire shield should as well. It's that simple. That's a pretty good breath attack, actually. That's kind of cool. Oh, he's gonna be getting the clone burst to hit the Nyxes, but that's not gonna be like one Nyx worth of damage. You may as well Ice Bolt better by that point. It's not like the Acer clone's doing any damage anyway. He could also be trying to chain. No, but the chain bosses would actually hurt him more. Interesting. Okay. He's picking a fireball, unironically. Okay, maybe slightly ironically, but still. Yeah, he's gonna be like fireballing, actually. Yeah, actual fireball in the Panalka. No, don't hit here. I don't think... No? Gonna be setting up to hit anywhere, everywhere with the air elemental here. Oh, yeah, pretty good. Chain. Chain only deals like 73 air elementals. It's not that many whatsoever. Yeah. Can Nyxus reach? No, they can't. They would have to either have to be teleported on go for the mode, like pretty slowly, unfortunately, for Garaka. Yeah. Okay, so the Black Dragon's turn is here. So what Kiraka needs to do is, I think that's what Gong needs to do is he needs to like force, yeah, I believe that Gong needs to force Kiraka into a position where he has to like summon spam, and then Gong can win pretty easily by that point by just spamming like Chain Lightning's back. It's really that simple, actually. Well, I say it's that simple, but I'm not sure if he can actually have the damage to force that situation out quite yet. But for example, what if he wanted to like just Ice Bolt and hit? Then he'd be like pressuring like lethal on the birds, right? That's pretty good. And then actually hitting gear on the earliest first, yeah, okay. And yeah, so now Kiraka in a situation where he's gonna be needing to summon to survive. Like Berserk dies otherwise immediately, and because of the moat. Wait, what is this? This is just his chain, right? Or maybe Lightning Bolt. I wonder if Lightning Bolt is good enough. It probably is. Gong's Lightning Bolt should be good enough. But no, he wants a chain anyway, just to like bounce a little bit to the Nyxus team. And maybe to his catapult team. He wants it to kill off his own catapult as soon as possible before the gates go down, actually. Who's Gong? Gong is the loyalty player on the left with Black Dragons. Kiraka is the Nyx Eovashius on the right. And the crowd is cheering for Tim. He could be Berserker. Wait, isn't it lethal? No, it's not. I guess it's... How does this work? Chain deals 4.90 to these guys. Wait, did he like hover our Lightning Ball though? I'm just interested if it one-shots or not. I believe it should be at the very least like very, very close. Because it's like twice over killing. If Lightning Ball deals less than half damage, I mean like more than half damage of the Chain Lightning, then it should already be good enough. And I think it is actually, yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hypnotize? Is Hypnotize lethal in any world? I don't believe so. But why? Why would you Hypnotize here? Like, he wins just by spamming chains for like 20 turns, actually. Actually, yeah, I think that 20 turns of Chain Lightning should be winning. No, but then he would like walk south, then he has to like go inside, so then the new early stacks are getting hit. Hurricane Protection Air. Wait, what did he do? Oh yeah, he ended up casting this. He ended up getting the Speed Prio. Okay. Well, Towers will just kill the Black Dragons in 20 turns. They tell us their presence, so they're like healing some as well. That's one thing. And the Catapult might still deal with some of the Towers here as well, maybe. We'll see. Okay. And the situation is basically the same, but like, I think that Kiraka has enough mana to cast for like all the fight. No, 100 times 20 is gonna be like 2k. Okay, he does not have mana for like 200 for 100 rounds, I guess. The Tower's actually, yeah, doing a number on the Black Dragons. All right. Deadlock. Well, I mean, there's no ties. It will end actually in one. Side winning 100% of the time. Chain here on the Nyxus would actually be dealing some damage, and the secondary bounce would actually almost kill all of these. Ellie. He could be waiting too, for now. Okay. Offer draw. Offer draw. No. He's berserking. Ooh, doesn't do enough damage. Damn. Shame. What does this do? It lets... I don't know. I don't know how I feel about this. Okay. A new early stack comes down. Why is Gong throwing? Shouldn't he just chain? Not necessarily. He wants to keep his mana flow, possibly. So one concern could be mana. Two concern could be like teleport, maybe. Wait, no, this is. No game, no life. Yeah, let's go back here. The game's still going on. Yeah, the Penalka is. Oh no, the gate was over open. Oh, but the Aces are able to block them. Wow. Okay, that's quite something. Ooh. And yeah, the chain came out for the. Oh, he actually set up the chain for the to kill the early stack, the secondary one. Interesting. Yeah, you cannot sacrifice hypnotized stacks, unfortunately. Yep. So, three more chains and can Hypno Nyxes ride. Three more chains and can Hypno Nyxes. Wait, what is the Hypno range? It's not that high. By the way, there's Elixir present too. So, it's gonna be like 1 on 6 per Nyx. Like, what can he do in terms of his hypnotize? 1k. Oh, so 1k? That's a, like what, 8 Nyxes? Why is Skip Banger? Reasons. Wait, cast Chain Lightning on the Catapult. Wait, why does he want to... Oh, he wants to kill the Catapult just so it doesn't kill the towers. Interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Catapult, I guess, already did its job, and... Garaga is gonna be, like, relying on the towers to kill the dragons long-term, with summons keeping him afloat. Wait, what? Wait, not sure what Garaga noticed. Oh, wait. He can walk around? Wait, what? Oh, what the hell? What? He didn't block the gate. He can move from, like, this hex to this hex. What? Okay. That's something. That is something. That is not something that I was aware of, yeah. Interesting. Bug. Yeah, I guess it's a bug? Or, like... What? What is the pathing there? Okay, okay. That's quite something. That's quite something. Interesting. Feature. Yeah, every single bug of Heroes 3 ended up being a feature. This being no exception. Wait, does he have lethal? Wait, does Gong have lethal? Wait, no, but like the, Wait, isn't it lethal? Berserk, move? No, it's not good enough. No, never mind, not lethal. Summons will be coming out right now, so, yeah. Wasn't that the bug that DG mentioned before? No, he was saying something about opening the gate in a bugged way. But I'm not sure if this is in. Yeah, I'm certainly not sure if this is in. Gong cannot afford to lose the birds here, by the way. Yeah. That's pretty unfortunate. But they will be lost soon. It's actually like such a close final fight. The towers will probably be like, making all the difference here in the end. Damn. Okay. Quite something in the end. He can soon Hypno Nyx. I mean, that would be relevant, sure, but it's like two more casts of Chain Lightning. Two more classes, like, actually something. You actually get punished by not moving the Berserker immediately. Yeah. By the way, Berserk and the Aces would actually give him back speed prior, because Berserk units actually lose hypnotize. That's something that I found out, like, a little while ago. But it seems like he's content with summoning. But I'm not sure if this will be good enough in time. Like, will this be good fast enough? Like, is there a way that he can reposition the aces for them to not die? Actually, if he goes to the north, it will only be the four bounds that would hit them on the next chain. You see? Because the first bounce would go to, like, the south side, I think. Then the second bounce would go to the 8 stack, and then the third bounce would go to the aces. And the third bounce might not kill the aces, which may just be good enough, actually. Okay. Frenzy is 200%! Do it! What? Frenzy the tower? What the hell? What are we talking about? Why not Ice Bolt? Because he wants to kill some of the air elementals as well. Here? I wonder if he calculated the damage to not kill these. Down to 6 black dragons. It's really close. But what if Gongwazi starts summoning? What? Wait! Doesn't Gongwazi went on summon spam? Wait! Gongwazi went on summon spam, doesn't he? Because, like, Kawaka's not even close to killing all these summons as they come out. He's, like, trying to find this lethal, but he doesn't need to. Redder's double his mana, I don't think so. Eventually, Gong would be overwhelming before the mana runs out. Like, this mana amount is ridiculous already. They both basically have infinite mana, that's how we should look at this fight for now. Why Ice Bolt? Because he doesn't want the burst to die. He got haste on Nyx. It's haste and prayer on Nyx, so yeah. Wait. Somebody asked Tim if he needs some air. It's not Tim, it's Gong! Did I say Tim again, by the way? Did I say it? I didn't say it, did I? No, Gong! Tim, shut up. Oh my god. Tim summoned the air. No, but I believe Gong just actually wins on air elementals, but anyone here is not allowed to, like, go to his shop, by the way. Strictly! It's not them, it's Gong. Okay. So, yeah. Currently, Karaka's already considering the hypnotize options of Gong here. Yeah. He's thinking, but it's gonna be, like, pretty hard. After the hypnotize happens, it's gonna be, like, really, really hard. But I mean, like, Gong just wins on summons. I wonder why he's, like, trying so hard to find, like, a different solution than to summon, you know? Because I think summon is, like, a foolproof solution for him, actually. Who's blue? I'm confused. Blue player is Gongwazi, and he's the one playing Lorelei in this best of three. Tim is blue, no. So yeah. Karaka applies the pressure, still. I wonder what the exact, Magic Mirror next. Wait, that's actually the play. Wow. Wow. I mean, even if the Magic Mirror were to trigger, that would actually just be preventing, like, one cast, not doing anything. Okay, so what is happening next? Fireball? Yeah, I guess he doesn't want to kill that many. Well, Fireball would be working around the Magic Mirror, and it would at the same time... It would, at the same time, be sending, like, not killing as many of them. Because after Gong gets the Nyxes, he doesn't even actually want them to die. And he wants to get, like, more of them as well. As he's gonna be, like, the one that's back to applying the pressure. Hmm. Okay. Magic mirror protects against the Sigma, by the way. I understand. It protects against the setup for magic mirror, as well as the magic mirror itself, yes. What is the magic mirror bounce to you? Nowhere. It's like, it will bounce and then it will get resistant, because it's bouncing to a magic immune creature, Black Dragon. So the animation would be, yeah, bounce into resist, and then it would be just over. Ooh, yeah, summons, come out, okay. Yeah, that's a win con. Yeah, that's a win con for sure. These summons aren't doing zero damage, but anyway. Yeah. The Nyxes go back. I believe that there has to be like one less Nyx for this to succeed. Yeah. Kill 0 to 3. Isn't Giant Lightning good then? It will bounce 3 times to Nyx. Yeah. It will set up this, Hypnotize. And now he can apply the pressure to the last of the Nyx of the early stack. Whilst chaining like all the new ones too. It's gonna be like very powerful. Yeah. I believe that Gong will be able to find a victory here. What a close Fenalka here, actually. Wow. Wow. Can't protect versus chain bounce. Yep. Chain comes out here, and he will actually be having like the... he doesn't know where to move to like protect. No, not this X. No. Yeah? Or maybe, yeah. No, I'm actually not sure. Does this protect against the Nyx walking out? Okay, it does. It does. Wait, what? Oh, he waited already. So now he can wait, and then the early stack will have to be the one that where he casts, actually. Then the Hypnotize can come out, and yeah, it's pretty good then. Oh, but the Hypnotize can still get, Magic Mirrored, actually. Wow, okay. Wow. Okay. Wait, what does Kiros... Oh, okay. So Gong's not going for the Magic Mirror play. Like, Gongwazi just now had a 40% chance to concretely win the game, but he chose not to pursue it, by the way. Yeah. Like, if Kiros summons, he's actually getting chained again, just like that. That's so sad for him, isn't it? Damn. Because, like, somebody makes your magic mirror actually useless here. That's kind of annoying, I would assume. Yeah, he will not be able to kill this in time. He does not have the time to do this. The towers will not apply enough pressure. You cannot hypno with units of magic mirror. They are immune. You cannot hypno Yupapega. Wait, what? What? What do you mean? They're immune? In addition to its main effect, Magic Mirror also makes its target immune to Hypnotize spell. What the hell? That's bizarre. Well, that's hella bizarre. Damn. Okay. I see. Fine, fine. Hella bizarre. I'm missing Dean. I mean, Magic Mirror being used unironically. Wow. That's quite something, actually. That's quite something. Yeah. Okay. He'd be getting 8 cows back by sacrificing. Wait, what is that? What does that cast? It was protection from air, wasn't it? Yeah, it was. He can just, like, chain the earlies anyway, right? Yeah, that's good enough. Then he can also hit if he wants to, but doesn't have to. Yeah. I think that's his best cast. But he could also, like, try and, summon as well, but... Yeah, this is probably better. Mm-hmm. Hits here? Yeah, hits here. Down to one Nyx only. And the next chain is gonna be, like, basically securing in. Because it will give the speed power back to Lorele. So Lorele is gonna be having, like, double cast, and that will be good enough. Yeah. Do it, Gong! Finish it! And now, the Black Dragons, against all odds, on their own, prevailed under the careful command of Gong. Gong navigated the series into a very close, tight, and exciting 2-1 win up against Karaga. Let's go! What a series. What a series. Well played, Gong. Well played, Karaga. It was an exciting series to watch, truly. Very nice, very nice. Truly. Woo! Gong vs. Karaga, winner 10. Gong won! Gong won, okay? Yes, indeed. Are you playing in 20? I just recently got knocked out, yeah. So, hope you guys had as much fun as I did here. I'll be seeing you next time. Until then, ciao ciao! You guys are still cheering on Tim, bro. Yes, of course. Anyhow, ciao ciao! Bye bye!